Today's parliament sitting, which unusually started at 10 a.m. in the morning, had been specifically dedicated to consideration of the 2023-2024 financial year budget, which had been slated to pass today.
To handle the budget today and finish it. We must apply today. Whether we reach whatever time, we must finish the budget. When we continue holding this budget estimates, so many things come in between. So let's supply, and we know that we've supplied. If we don't do today, finance will come tomorrow again with another addendum.
However, the Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, shocked the House with an addendum to the corrigenda for the draft budget estimates for the financial year 2023-2024, further revising the budget upwards to 52.7 trillion shillings, which was sent to the Budget Committee for reconsideration.
Addendum to the corrigenda for the draft budget estimates for the financial year 2023-2024, I beg to lay.
Thank you. The latest addendum proposes to increase the budget by about 850 billion shillings, but there are contentious matters in that addendum. The first one is the allocation of the 70 billion shillings for the factory by a private investor around Matuga for pharmaceutical products. Most Ugandans will recall how somebody masqueraded as a professor from, I think, America, and they had indicated they would produce vaccines for Ugandans.
However, this did not go well with legislators, who expressed disappointment with the Minister of Finance for bombarding Parliament with new budget revisions on the 11th hour, which deprives legislators of time to make proper scrutiny of figures before they are considered in the appropriation bill.
The Budget Committee, we feel, in fact, we are waiting, Madam, for an opportunity to present. So is there no limit that they can every 2 hours walk out and come back with a revision? The budget
that his documents are increasingly unreliable and incomplete. Will he lay a statement attesting to their reliability? Because incompetence and unreliability is now becoming an art form of sorts from finance.
Let's have whatever documents that you want this house to consider in time. But this should be the last time that you're bringing the corrigenda when we are 2 hours to supply.
In this regard, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, suspended the sitting for 2 hours and directed the Minister of Finance to provide an assurance to Parliament that the addendum tabled before Parliament is the last budget revision.
Speaker, in as far as the budget for financial year 2023-2024 is concerned, I confirm that this is the last document we are laying.
Oh, Musasizi, will it cause any harm for you to go and make a commitment in writing to this house and you come back and lay it on table that this is the last document? We don't want to be seen to be forcing finance. The other time we passed a law here and Attorney General said we forced him.
Although the Budget Committee was given 2 hours to consider corrections in the budget, as reflected in the addendum, by the time the House resumed after midday, the committee had not made any progress and Parliament was adjourned to tomorrow.
Speaker and honourable members, I beg that you give us 2.5 hours from now to have work done properly. Because the instance of the corrigenda is making corrections to the budget. And we have seen a number of local governments, so we have to be careful.
Legislators have castigated the Minister of Finance for making last-minute corrections that drastically affect several agencies.
It started as 50 trillion, it became 51, it is now 52. And Budget Committee was given 2 hours to scrutinize, because the law says you scrutinize 800 billion shilling. Even if you are angels, there is no way you're going to scrutinize 8 billion shilling in 2 hours. So this delay by the committee has been occasioned by a government that wants to act in darkness. So they want to throw huge figures at MPs because they know they will not read, and then you come carrying them on your head. No, 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 you can't do that.
Some lawmakers believe that the last-minute corrigendas are done deliberately to create no space for proper scrutiny of the budget.
If there is a mess, it's finance that should answer to this mess.
The Public Finance Management Act places an obligation onto Parliament to approve the budget estimates before the end of May. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.